Hello everyone. In this video, we will see what is meant by batch normalization. So basically, normalization is applied on the input features. Input features are if from the different range, then by applying normalization, we are bringing those features to a zero-centered data with standard deviation of 1. Okay, so this helps us to get more accurate result in the neural network. This is for the input data. So if input data is normalized, we will get better input for the first layer. But what is the scenario in the hidden layer? So let's check out that. And we will try to understand why there is a need for batch normalization. So normalized data is received by the first layer. Now inside that each neuron, we are going to perform W transpose X plus B, and we are applying non-linearity to it. Okay, so the output generated by this particular layer will be taken as an input by the next layer. Now this activations generated by the neural network will have different distribution of data unlike the input. Okay, so this will be the case for rest of the layers also. So next layer will be getting input as the output generated by its previous layer. Again, the data distribution over here might be different one. So this distribution is again changing during the neural network training because we are updating the weights and with the time, which will be quite difficult for the neural network in order to get the better results. That's why we have to use batch normalization. Now let's see how it is removing this problem. Whichever the process we have applied for the input data, the same procedure is applied over the activations generated by the neural network, which will bring all the activations to again zero centered data with the standard deviation of 1. So this will help us to bring this generated neural network to one distribution and we will get the better result. So this will be done on the batch. That's why it is called as batch normalization. Now let's check out how to use batch normalization with the model. Okay, this is our previously created model. We have created input layer, after that we have specified three dense layer, and last is output layer. We have compiled that model and we have trained our model with model.fit. So we have received accuracy up to 87% on the training data and 90% on the validation data. Now let's add batch normalization in this model. So in TensorFlow, batch normalization can be added as a layer in the model. So let us add batch normalization layer tf.keras.layers.batch normalization. That's it. Okay, so this particular layer is responsible for bringing all the activations to zero centered values with standard deviation 1. Now this will be applied for the second hidden layer and third hidden layer also. Okay, so let me execute this cell. In summary, we can see that batch normalization layers are added after second hidden layer, third hidden layer and first hidden layer. Now let me compile this model and let's try to train the modified model on the training data. Okay, so we have received accuracy up to 93% for training and 95% for the validation. Now this is improvement in accuracy for training as well as validation data set. So by using batch normalization, we are getting more accurate result than without using the batch normalization. So batch normalization works in a different way than the other layers in the tf.keras.layers. So batch normalization updates the activations in forward pass only. So in backward pass, we will update the weight, and in forward pass, activations will be updated by the normalization layer to bring all the activations to zero centered and standard deviation 1. This will improve the result. So this is how batch normalization can be included in our model. Thank you for watching the video.